talked about the fact that they are a single team, and I think it showed there. They stuck themselves together well as a team. So, Mitch, we move on to map number three. Lijiang Tower.
Lijiang Tower, which is very interesting for me now because we've kind of seen both these two teams showcased in different payloads. Now moving over towards Control, which is generally a bit more of a brawl-focused game type, which is great in my opinion for Thailand, who seem to be very, very good at playing these mentally taxing scenarios where you need to be, you know, at high APM or actions per minute for a long period of time, right? Opito, for example, you don't stay alive and do so much damage just by, you know, hanging around and sort of just observing. You need to be in and out of the fight, dashing in, throwing shurikens, staying alive most importantly. So this will be very interesting now as Thailand in terms of their lineup. Opito showing us quite a lot of depth to his hero pool. He's been the one that's switching between DPS, now going over towards a Reaper.
And if you've just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, you obviously may have seen throughout it, King's Row is a what's known as a hybrid map. Obviously, you capture the payload and you move it along through the points. Then we moved on to an assault map. That was a simple case of capturing point A and B. Now, this is called a control map. All you got to do, simple, there's a point in the middle, in this case, Night Market. You will capture that. You can see the big defense sign on your screen. It will unlock in 25 seconds. And it is simply hold on as long as you can until you hit the 100% mark. And here we go.
Good to see Jamli back on McCree as well. That's kind of what he's known for over in China from IGI. So let's see what he can do with that though now, as both these teams sort of set up in the middle of the map. It's kind of the agreed way to play Night Market. You start here and then you transition to the point. But Meng Mao goes down first. Opito has actually been let off the leash a little bit there, getting two kills. That's going to at the very least force China back. And Opito gets a third. No one's responding to this Reaper right now. For whatever reason, Jamli couldn't find him amongst the mix and deal with him. Opito was the one that got to him. McCree should dominate at that sort of medium to long range area, especially against a Reaper.
I think he had to have used the buildings on the left. It may have just flanked around. I don't know how it worked out, but you can see five eliminations, not a single death yet, because he managed to just run through the entire Chinese team. And that's a pressure situation. Now, China, as a nation in esports, generally gets in on themselves if they lose a map. Now, this is a little worry, I feel, for China fans out there, because it happened time and time again across multiple games. And I'm going to keep my eye on their expressions and their body language as we go through this one, because at the moment, Thailand are looking pretty dominant here on the first control map.
Opito all over the scoreboard right now. 10 eliminations, 0 deaths. He's been involved in pretty much all of this fighting. Now that Thailand have the point, China can't just go to the point and retake it. They have to fight Thailand in the middle of the map first, then win, then get to the point. That's a heck of a lot to do. Now, Opito, a little bit
that was
wishful
weird
there. I don't think he was done if he was hoping for maybe his Iron Shield or something a bit more.
I think he thought more didn't even have a nano. Yeah, he dropped down and there was only one person there. I think he was expecting, like, probably maybe have the signal that they're all coming around, but that put whole of Thailand in a real, real tricky situation. There's a good Deadeye. He is going to get caught out by the Blizzard, though, but there's going to be no follow-up. Pange gets himself a quick double, and the point will flip over to China. So 64% was the marker that Thailand reached there. 65 just hit ticks in the end there. NZNR just throwing himself off to get the respawn with the rest of his team. Now, how will China do? So, a questionable decision there from Opoto. He was doing very well. They tried a risky ulti play. Now they're going to have to turn it around in their favor.
Yeah, I mean, that's not what really hurt them, I guess. Jamli had a great spot for Deadeye there and it followed up well with Pange. But now Opoto again is going to enter the fight from an off angle here. Try and sneak in. He's got the sound barrier on him now as well. He's looking to try and get up close and personal with Pange, but he survives. Pange is still alive. Somehow Meng Mao now going to reciprocate and even then some more. He's going to up the ante on Opoto, getting himself two kills, going in with a Death Blossom. And Jamli and Pange finish off the fight for China. 35% and counting here. Thailand will need to retake after this next fight.
So, plenty of time to go. No time for panic. This is a five-map extravaganza, the first of three here. And that's going to be an earth shatter that's not going to catch too many, but it does the job. Pange going wild with the hammer, gets himself a quick double. And the rest of Thailand are forced to scurry back into their spawn. China will have themselves the advantage in this next fight. They will have the percentage ticking in their favor. But Opoto will have himself the Death Blossom ready and waiting to go along with Kurlos, so expect to see that stack ulti working.
Yeah, Jamli looking at his setup now. This is a Deadeye position, right? He's going to stay safe. He's not going to do a lot of damage with left clicks, but now China has to respect this, or at least Thailand does. Wall's going to come up. Going to make it hard for Jamli to get the damage done here, but at least into the back line, Meng Mao does die. Jamli gets frozen up and then charged out by KO KFC, and Opoto has a good opportunity to use his Death Blossom, but he needs China to be all sort of stuck together. He'll satisfy satisfy himself for now, going for Naiva and the supports in the back line. To be fair, even Pungay has to respect this.
Yeah, Apotu backs away, the rest of his team in position, so that actually worked out quite well for them. Remember Kurloss, who's he nano boosted? He didn't go for Apotu, so I'm not too sure. Didn't see who he managed to nano boost down. Looked like Desire off the side there, I think it was. Managed to get in there. Yes, it was. It was Mickey that he managed to nano boost, so I'm not too sure on that one, but either way, it hasn't worked for them, and China will keep hold of the point.
China coming back through there. You see Thailand managed just to get 3 out of 6 kills and then sort of rotate through, but that worked out quite nicely. But if Punk-A was very well involved in that one. He had an anaboost of his own. That's how you deal with a Tracer, though. Ends it in. Arden's going to go face-to-face with the Peacemaker, and Jam Lee starts fights and also finishes them. That was the desperation attempt for Thailand. They possibly could have actually gone a little bit slower about this one, but now there's no time. All they're going to do is try and keep going at this point. Now, yep, Kurloth's going to be knocked aside. Graviton used on the outside. There's no chance for Thailand to come back into this one, and the first round will go to China.
So, Night Market goes across to the Chinese team. Thailand currently at 1 apiece, and in game, of course, we are 1-0. It is a best of 5 on Lijiang Tower to decide the outcome of this game in Group C. Very dramatic music to go across their faces, I feel there.
Absolutely. Someone has scored a basket there as well, thankfully. Look, I've got to say as well, Jam Lee, I'm glad to see him on this McCree. I did mention it earlier on here. This is what he's known for. He's very, very good at it. And you can see that how, if Jam Lee is given space to work, what he can do with it. He was actually hitting about 64% of his shots in that game. Now, that's very, very high. Yeah. Even for McCree pros, normally it's like between 46 and 56. That's like, okay, solid. This guy has been above and beyond that. So look to see him sort of do a bit more now in these closer quarters on Garden. Okay, fair enough to see the Reaper come out, but YJP is back on the Pharah, as is NZNR.
Well, Potu's made the switch, of course. He's now on the McCree, was on the Reaper in the previous map. So we'll see how his hitscan works there. But Kurloss managing to take down YJP, and that's probably going to give them the point here. Thailand should be capping out. Will unlock in 3 seconds time, and it looks like China are already backing up. They have to wait for that respawn. So we'll see how the Pharah works out for both these teams.
Well, now China have to go in from the right side here. It's very, very hard to challenge the bridge when the enemy team has control of the point. Jam Lee goes down to NZNR, which is kind of interesting to see the McCree being on that side of the kill feed in that case. But that's not a good start for China. They are going to have to, again, redouble their efforts and regroup here. Losing that McCree so early, not good.
Not good, but China are not really forcing the issue. They're not able to get in around that. With Jam Lee down, now he's coming back from spawn, but you already saw NZNR managing to land the rockets down. They're going to clump themselves up, and the barrage is not too far away, you know. This might backfire on them, gets a little knock away, the shield manages to keep them sound, gets around the side, gets a little flankeroo, now the barrage is ready and waiting to go. He's going to back himself away and just blast it in the face of Jam Lee. No chance there, and that will be Thailand keeping them at bay.
Yeah, that's a panic button for NZNR. He's like, no, I need to deal with that McCree now, but hey, he got more than he bargained for there. We saw the Oppito was able to get involved with some of that, those kills, as well as McCree offside. So Thailand still holds this point. Now you're getting a little bit stressed as China. You don't have a huge bank of ultimates to work with. You do at least have the nano boost, but you're going to have to hope that that really works out. It's probably going to have to be Pungay to receive this one, given this team composition.
Yeah, just 2-3 failed attacks, and suddenly you're looking at a 60% plus, and they're going to try and go around the backside once again, but this time around they're going to be facing an Earth Shatter from KOKFC. You can see there's the Graviton Surge now ready to go from Mickey as well. He's got himself charged up to 80%, and they're still taking hits. They're taking rockets. This is less than ideal for China as they try and push around. YJP's going to try and be the flanking man. He's got himself the barrage. He tries to push around there. Doesn't get the knockoff. Wanted the concussive blast to knock the Ana off the bridge. It doesn't work out, but Jam Lee's managed to find NZNR.
There's still a good opening to this fight here for China now. They actually retake the point. Thailand try and disengage, but as they disengage, they're now being cut down one by one. You're better off just dying. The whole team straight away. You can see them trying to jump off the edge now because they backed away from China for whatever reason, didn't want to fight. Maybe just wanted to build an old advantage, or even more than that, draw ultimates out of China so Thailand can come back. If they get the point one more time, they're pretty much going to win the round. They didn't get the draw much out of China. That's kind of the problem. So now they've got to go head-to-head, 3 ults versus 3 ults into this next fight.
Ballsy play. They're running up against the Graviton Surge and a barrage, so that combo is certainly available, and it will be available on both sides, actually. They're going to try and use the advantage and remove the Pharah from the screen. But there's going to be the barrage. There's going to be the Graviton Surge. But it is going to be countered by the Sound Barrier. And he gets himself a double. He got the Zaya down in there. And it will stop the attack from Thailand down. KOKFC is going to get cleared off the point. And China will hold on.
Yeah, you're still happy with that. You know, Sound Barrier is good. Not really good when you've got a barrage and they're all being held together. So now Jamly as well, getting his hands a little bit dirtier on the point. Flash comes in to deal with Kurloss. Now, he has to be careful. Oppito was going to try and pick him up here. Needs to be careful how far out he peeks. But of course, he'll be able to get a good amount of information now as Thailand make their move. China have made 60% up on this capture progress, which is great. And they have an Earth Shatter in Punge's hands, which can win the fight, especially when KOKFC is a long way away from his here.
A nano boost from Naibei could be crucial. Oh, some sniping nice shots on NZ. And oh, look at his health. He's just got two blips left. Absolutely picked off before he even leaves his spawn point there from Naibei. So really working him down. There's going to be the nano boost. Uh-oh, that's going to be Reinhardt picking him off. He's going to get charged out of the way, taken all the way back to the spawn point. So Thailand do manage to remove him. But, well, Punge will go down, but it doesn't matter. The rest of his team, job done. 89% and counting. China suddenly in the ascendancy here.
They've got big odds to work with now. Deadeye's going to come through just to try and zone away. Jamly's trying to back away. He's got a Reinhardt in his face, though. Flash comes down. KOKFC falls. And now Jamly gets sleep darted. Very nicely done there. But it's not going to be enough. Kurloss tries to put the man to sleep. But again, he's got a bit of teammates to help him out there. It's going to be Meng Mao and YGP chiming over the fight. And they will hold this point. Thailand looked good at the start of that round, Lee. But China assert their dominance late again.
I'd love to look back and see exactly what their thinking was, because they weren't really attacked on the site. They weren't really pushed off the site. They kind of chose to back away from the site. And then, I don't know, for whatever reason, because they had the Graviton Surge, they had the Barrage that were available, yet they backed away.
Yeah, I mean, whether they sort of disengaged that fighter or forced to or not back, whatever. The point is that Thailand gave up the point without inducing ultimates to be spent from China, yeah. Right? China didn't have to spend any ultimates at all. And that's huge on a map, on maps like these control maps, where those ultimates and the balance of those ultimates actually decide the outcome of fights. If you're going to allow the point to be taken away, don't spend ultimates if you know you've already lost the fight. That's the first one. And secondly, make it costly for the enemy team. So you know on the retake, you'll have even more control than you did before.
Oh, Night Market and Garden going the way of China. They are 2-0 up and one round away from taking this game 2-1 over Thailand. And here we are on Command Center, and already, well, it's looking pretty good for Thailand. It started off well for them on all three maps so far. The question is, can they hold it? It's going to unlock in a moment. They're going to cap it out. And it will be China once again that are forced to go for the retake.
All right, so ZP brought it up earlier on as well. The reason why we're not seeing Jamly on the McCree is that a lot of players feel that sort of control center is a little bit better for Reaper. McCree, I mean, you can close the gap on McCree much easier on this map than some others, like, I guess, Night Market, for example. Oh, the wall comes up, and Punge's able to just cheat death and get away from the charge. Now Jamly's looking for the backline here. Let's see if this Reaper can make an impact. Well, no, Hook comes in. Oppito, really nasty on the execute there. Two kills for him in that fight. Again, featuring heavily on the scoreboard.
And we've seen nice adjustments from Oppito. Bearing in mind, he was a McCree over on the first map. Now he's been on the Reaper, and now he's on the
played
the Roadhog,
Genji as well,
so
on Hanamura.
Yeah, he's played Genji as well. So clearly a jack of all trades, 20 kills and 8 deaths to his favor so far. But NZNR sitting on that Blizzard, that's going to be useful for Thailand. This is a very enclosed space, and that Blizzard can be crucial, along with Kurloss, of course, with the Nano Boost.
Those ultimates, like you said, Lee, are going to be crucial in this fight.
Okay.
That Blizzard was one of the
Bastion for a moment there. I was like, ooh!
I've seen it happen once in China, really. Work out well. We'll leave that for another time, but this Blizzard's going to be massive. Wall comes up. They're going to try and isolate Punge now as well. Easy as that. Then the Blizzard comes in. You've got a 6v5 with the Blizzard. You're definitely going to win this fight out. This is Thailand playing it very cleverly here off the back of the ultimates they've built up. And Lee, they've still got three.
Yeah.
They can hold off for longer.
Very good ulti management there. Resources being perfectly used and perfectly played by NZNR there. He's walled it off a couple of times now, absolutely separating Punge from the rest of his team, and it's worked out perfectly for him this time around, and they have to. This is the do or die time now for Thailand, of course. Mickey got himself that Graviton Surge. Look out for that one, of course, the Roadhog with the Hole Hog to force them back. But they're going to try and drop in from around the middle here. They're going to try multiple angles. Jamly going to go in, boosted up by the Nano Boost. Is it going to be enough? Lincoln comes in. He gets himself the double kill, picking up the pieces, I feel, from Jamly there, but it looks like China may well have just done enough to force them off at 97%.
Yeah, Jamly just surviving that one there as well. That was pretty rough. He gets a second kill off the back as Oppito falls down. Look, that's what happens when you actually send a Reaper into a fight without a Zarya shield. Now, that whole hog coming out for Oppito would have burned down any Zarya shield that was on Jam Li after a while, but it probably would have been enough. Jam Li could have gotten at least the kill on the Ana. Doesn't matter, but this is why I'm saying that that Reaper Copter combo that we talk about does need a little bit of, you know, excess ult to facilitate. Graviton going to come in, though.
Killed all five people, I think maybe six. There's going to be a pulse bomb on top of it! And YJP says, thank you very much. I will fill the kill feed with my name. Oppito, the last man standing. They're just going to let him die slowly. And that's actually going to buy China quite a bit of time. They just used simply two ultis. That's all that was required. And it will buy them a time, of course. They can't afford to lose a single fight, so they have to keep this going for around about three or four fights running.
Well, let's see if it's going to work out. Good. That's nice work with the icicles there from NZNR. Gets himself two kills. That's a huge opening, and now that's going to force the ultimate out for Pungay there. Earthshatter is going to be big, though. Catches two up. KOKFC is dashed aside. Pungay finds NZNR as well, but now Oppito come in with a response. He's shielded up for a short while, but now he needs to find this Lucio on the point. He needs to deal with this now so they can retake it. Thailand in a good position to flip it back here in China now. They're going to be forced into full desperate stall mode.
How on earth did that happen? I just don't even know. YJP's back on point. He's trying to keep them at bay, but he's just going to get caught off. Gets himself the pulse bomb down there. Oh, a quick blast to the face of Jam Li says thank you very much. They're coming in splintered now, one by one. They're getting picked off, and Thailand have this one in the back. The whole hog going to blast them away. And I just don't understand. That was simply NZNR catching with the icicles, caught out both Jam Li and YJP. And suddenly it was like, bang, your DPS players are gone. Just coming back from that simple spawn, whether they've just come too aggressive, overly aggressive, I don't know. It's obviously happened a number of times, but it's 2-1 nonetheless.
The thing is, as well, when you're facing up against the Roadhog, you do need to be obviously very careful of the hook. And what I mean is that if you want to set up in from two different angles on a map like this, right, where control center you could work in from the right and the middle, one of these arms of your team, one of these pincer arms, is going to be without a Reinhardt. Guess what? That means you're very vulnerable to Roadhog hooks. Oppito only had about a 33% hook accuracy, but he was throwing out a ridiculous amount of them, and that's allowing him to get these early picks in the fights. And then, if a Reaper gets up in his face like he did just then, one shot to the breadbasket, it's an easy kill with Roadhog at close range.
Very elegantly phrased there. Group D is where we're at, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Overwatch World Cup. If you've just joined us, you've missed off some fantastic games, some real eye-openers throughout the world, of course. All the teams attended, and we are back once again on the garden to see how it's going to work out. Currently 2-1 here on Lijiang Tower for the decider.
Sorry, that's the hook I was telling you about, and YJP is going to fall foul of it there. It's very easy to get those kills when they're right in your face, of course. That's where the shotgun excels. Also, bit of a side note as well, if Oppito does turn to the right after hooking, it's because he's just hooked a lighter target that sometimes don't get pulled as close as he would like. And stepping to the right and actually moving slightly in the right direction after hitting a hook will pull that target closer. A little bit of a trick for your Roadhog players out there.
Yeah, a little cheeky. It's almost like a flick shot for a hog.
But you don't want to move before the hook and you'll miss it. It's a bit weird, but if you get it right, it's nice.
Okay, China. Well, this seems a repeatable situation many times. They are on the retake. Once again, they're going to have to push in, but this time it might well work out for them. Pangay gets in there. YJP comes around the side and suddenly a sleep dart on Pangay is not enough to null the Chinese defenses, and they're going to push on through. Graviton Surge used now.
That's okay. I'll tell you why in a second here as well, as Thailand can sort of work around the side of this one. Essentially, 40% already, and then Mickey comes back in. So not only does it buy time on the point, but it buys time for reinforcements. China flip it back, but now Thailand actually have a strong position where China have to filter through across the bridge, and it's scary! Yes. It's dangerous when the hook's coming in. Jam Li going to get pulled up for dinner, and it's as easy as that.
Oppito has really impressed me in this game so far. He's going to get himself another there. That shield is not going to handle the strength of the whole hog. And it is going to be Thailand that will flip it back. So this time it works out well for them. But look at the ulti stack for China. They're still in a good position to go for the retake once again.
I want to point out as well that China actually as a team have about 25% more healing for their team than Thailand do as well. That makes a big deal over these maps.
Oh,
when you're doing similar damage, that healing's important. And look, that's as simple as that, right? Roadhog is very good in this position. You need to respect him. You need to try and remove him. A sleep dart is not a bad way to deal with Oppito in this position. It gives you a window to just go and charge the bridge. But this is why it sucks to play from behind against a Roadhog on this map.
Yeah, well, that one hook bought him 10%. It bought them 10% on that counter. YJP going down. Of course, they have full 6 ulti charge coming into this fight, whereas Thailand have 1. It's going to be a very tricky fight for Thailand to win.
Well, Obito back and away now as well. The Graviton comes in, but he's free of it now. Let's see what damage he can do around the side. Hook into Palm Gate. He can't get close enough. The Reinhardt, I guess, being prevented from getting involved in the battle and getting his hands dirty. But still, Jamli and Meng Mao, the damage dealers, have managed to deal with most of Thailand in that fight, and they will be able to clean it up here. But it's getting very close, and this point being kept contested for so long here by, I believe it was Mickey. 98% to 17 is what that's given us.
Lose a simple fight and it's over, but Thailand lost this at what, 80% last time? Actually, I think it was 99% last time on Garden. And they could not retake it. They could not get it back from China. China needed all six ultis to do it. Let's see what Thailand can do. They're going to have themselves, what, five ultis coming back into this next fight, I feel, as they stack it out. They're already sneakily capping it around the back while this fight happens. Mickey comes in, gets it double triple, make it five! And Mickey goes huge! China get decimated, and Thailand will take the round.
That's what you need. Just the Zarya coming in there. Perfect use of the Graviton Surge. Like you said, Lee, even despite that, Thailand were working their way in around the side. They even had a Blizzard available to use later on in that fight. Good ultimate management pays dividends here on maps like these. And now we're going to be going to a fifth to decide not just this third map, but the entire series. And the realization of that now, you can see it almost occurring to Thailand. We might just be able to take down China here, a team that we feared and respected for a long time and been waiting to play. And for China, this would be a disappointing result for them, given that, I mean, there's so much on their shoulders, there's so much self-belief for them and also from their fans. They don't want to fall at this hurdle, otherwise their qualification from the group itself is going to be in question.
They were big favorites for the group, no doubt about it. France and Singapore, obviously, in the group alongside. I'm going to be watching this one with bated breath and wondering which way this could fall, because it would certainly carve the group wide open. Everybody almost pigeonholed China and the top slate in this group. So here we go. It's Command Center. It is going to be all or nothing for China and Thailand. The hook goes straight through, but it doesn't net a kill.
Yeah, good response from YJP to get the shield up here now. Both teams are dropping back and forth. Those Reinhardt shields are very important. But Obito again gets another hook in. YJP again the time. Still, he's alive. It's almost as if he's trying to focus down that Zarya. So far, hasn't got it, but the third hook is going to do the job. That's 100%. 3 for 3 for Obito, and he finally gets his kill. However, he's losing teammates.
Yeah, the rest of his team not able to get them kills. They're going to back away from this one. It's not going to work out. And that's the first time in this Li Zhang series that China have taken the point first across all five maps. So, is that a good sign? Is that an omen? Who knows?
Well, hook again coming straight through. Meng Mao now needs to follow up on the fact that Pungay got hooked, but Zalfix actually the one to get the kill. Now Meng Mao backing away, realizes he needs to stay with the rest of his team, and that Reinhardt shield is still an issue. Mickey coming forward, he's charged up and ready to go, and Obito giving it the whole hog. Even the sound barrier is going to be wasted in the face of Thailand pushing forward now. That will retake this point. The hook as well. Obito really just doesn't miss many of these at all.
He is super accurate, you know. For a player so versatile, this is what we've seen. He's played five heroes throughout this series already, and well, his hog seems to be one of the best. Who knows? It seems to be working out well for him. The wall goes down, and that's going to buy themselves a bunch of time. The Blizzard is ready and waiting to go from NZNR. But there's another hook. Goodbye, Meng Mao. You're not going to play in this game. It's a bit of a wasted Blizzard, perhaps, potentially there, but it buys him enough time. He gets himself another couple of kills, and finally, he misses a hook. He got Nai Bay with it. It killed him. It didn't hook him in.
That's not a wasted hook in this scenario, because Meng Mao had Death Blossom available. Naiba had also his Nano Boost. But the fact that Meng Mao got hooked in with ult means that Naiba was forced to try and Nano Boost someone else, who I believe was Pungay. So China are wasting ults and using them in not optimal scenarios because Obito is finding the right targets to pick out.
Oh, that's a good Graviton Surge, but it's back, answered back and forth. Oh, look at that! Jamli gets himself boosted up in the air and gets himself a quick Deadeye. That had to have been what boosted him up there.
What? Had to get up on the top platform?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, he could have walked. It could have been a wall being thrown up there as well, I believe. As well,
but there's no May. I didn't know what boosted him up. I didn't know whether there's a Graviton Surge sucking him up. I don't know, maybe. But either way, he suddenly rides the platform. Actually, yes, of course, it could have been probably NZNR. Oh, wow. So NZNR's wall himself actually screwed them. Either way, China cap the point. 54% and counting. And now Pangay has himself his ulti ready. He's boosted up. And that is not going to be an Ana that's going to last long. Kurlos batted down.
Yeah, even Obito couldn't save his teammate there as well with the whole hog. Wasn't quite enough.
Oh, dear.
Someone's going for a long charge off a short plank.
What are you doing?
Both of them have fallen here. here. If you're China, it's okay to sacrifice and trade one for one here. I mean, not the ideal target. And you see Titan now trying to respond. They're trying to punish this move by throwing the Blizzard down. Now NZNR just going to go to the point on his own. There's no one there even to see this. It's unlikely he'll be able to take this in its entirety before Meng Mao can contest, but that's a weird passage of play.
The rest of his team are back, though. They're all coming back around the side. This has actually made it a really awkward situation. The wall goes down, segregates the team. Meng Mao gets himself quickly healed up there by Biotic Grenade, and this has actually caused a really tricky scene. Meng Mao, though, there's the sound barrier coming down. China should get control of the situation now because there isn't a great ulti resource coming 98%. Out from Thailand, and this may well be enough to take it. 99% and done for China. They will take the series 2-1, but by God, were they tested by Thailand.
What a fantastic way for this to go down to the wire as well. And perhaps it wasn't omenly that China, finally on that last stage of Lijiang Tower, took the point first, and despite losing it at one or two occasions, managed to reestablish their dominance. You saw, you know, it was getting very tight. That situation where we did see the mutual Graviton Surge being used could have gone either way, but I mean, there you have it. China do manage to get through, but we've seen that they can bleed.
Absolutely. That was not an easy game for China, and you can see, I think, almost relief on their faces there as they're just breathing a sigh. So, who is going to challenge them? Who knows? What do we take from that one? Of course, the desk already in waiting to see how take us through the analyst for that segment.
If you want to bring that one up and talk about
the ultimate. Thank you so much, G-Man. Guys, we have... we're still
we're so excited.
that was great. We saved up a whole bunch of replays to talk through with you guys, and right off the bat, I mean, we're gonna go all the way back to Hanamura. Forget King's Row. Are we even going to King's Row?
Well, Symmetra was cool on King's Row.
She was.
I enjoyed that.
It was very cool.
It was cool to see someone try to play Symmetra on point two on King's Row, yeah. But it was overshadowed by the rest of the match, really.
Absolutely.
Believe it or not.
Kings Row, we're going to appreciate you. We'll set it aside. Check out the VODs later, guys. Let's dive right into Hanamura because this was spectacular.
It was. And we're going to talk here as we go into a replay with the May player NZNR from the side of Thailand. And it shows really not only... we're just going to go right into it right
here. Go.
Yeah.
I did want to pause, but watch. What's important here is to watch the turret placement and basically slowing the nano-boosted Reaper as he comes in, followed by the freeze, followed by the ice block, followed by the wall. There are so many ways that we have in Overwatch to stop these nano-boosted Reapers, but it usually requires a chain of crowd control abilities. And in this case, you could see by staggering the Symmetra turrets along the path, you provided the continuous CC combined with the Mei, and it proved to be sort of a one-and-a-half player hold on the Reaper and really showed how well this team is used to playing the Symmetra and the Mei together on that defense. And that's not something you can really practice for, so it's understandable that China was probably a bit thrown considering most teams would not utilize that strategy. But if you can do it well, you can execute, it can be effective.
Yeah, it's been amazing watching the evolution of Symmetra turret placements. It's not something we get to see acted out too much through professional play, but really some hot tips there for you guys playing at home on Hanamura.
Well, yeah, I mean, putting the turrets like right underneath the edge of that wooden platform where it drops down just a little bit, that's the place to put them on Hanamura. And, you know, once you get past that as the offense, then there's not really any turrets on the point, so it's easy to take. But you can be held at that doorway for a long time.
Absolutely.
And we have to kind of mention the fact that Thailand was really slow to adapt over the course of the entire series, but we really saw it shine when it went to Hanamura and especially Lijiang Tower, where they finally figured out like the sweet spot. On Lijiang Tower, they really struggled holding onto the point, or retaking it, most importantly, once they lost the point.